Welcome to the concluding unit of this week. This week, we will be discussing how to deploy OER. You have put on a lot of work into creating, adapting your OER. It's important to develop marketing and promotion plan to share what you've done to ensure that it's used broadly. To deploy your OER, you will need to develop a plan of activity. In traditional publishing model, marketing and promotion are completed for authors. For open education, however, you will need to get the word out there yourself about your resources. This unit gives us some tips on how to promote and deploy your OER. Marketing plan consideration. Identify your key audience. This is especially important for textbooks, where those who select the book for course use may not be the one who uses the book during the course. Depending on the audience, you might have to develop separate marketing plans or different messages depending on the audience. Timelines. Work backwards from your target release date to distribute workload and allocate time for task. Message. You do not have to wait until your OER is complete to send out messages about the upcoming resource. There are several different milestones you can share along the way on your final product. You can share content updates, for example, completed chapters, sections, and so on. Information about team members behind the work, aspects of inclusivity, accessibility, diversity in your concept, content, and design, and engage with new ideas and opinions to connect with relevant current discourse. The important part of your messaging is to tell your story honestly and transparently. Promotional spaces. Once you have shared your OER in an online environment such as Open Educational Repository, Catalog, and so on, you will have to promote it. Word of mouth is always a good place to begin, as a grassroots method has the potential to gain authentic use of your resource. Additional promotional spaces such as social media, LinkedIn, can bring an international community to your work. Spaces to share your OER. Use communication support at your various institutions. Provide accessibility feedback too, such as survey, contact form, and so on, so that communications can be two-way. Notify your professional association and related organizations. Get the word out early and often using different channels, such as blogspots, social media, like Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, and so on, LinkedIn in your discipline and across community, email signatures, conferences, and webinars. Ensuring your OER reaches the intended audience is a crucial part of the publishing process. Indeed, if a granting organization is funding your activity, they may want to see that their investment is justified via extensive usage of the resource by the intended audience. This section outlines potential open access distribution channels to support usage of your textbook. Metadata. Before distributing your OER, you will need to develop a standard metadata structure. Metadata is structured descriptive information that describes your information objects. This information will be used when you upload and share your textbook in different platforms. Be sure to decide on the terms of use. Do you want to release your work under a Creative Commons license or in the public domain? Creative Commons license, you can retain ownership, allowing others to use your work under the terms that you have selected based on the license you choose. They still need to attribute you, but they don't need to ask your permission directly. Public domain, you waive your copyright ownership because you're basically giving your work to the public as a gift. Users may cite you when adopting your work, but they don't have to. Projects, organizations, and catalogs. Share the news about your resource with your discipline, various information channels. Think about presenting your project at conferences related to your field. Ask open textbook projects and OER organizations to spread the word about your resource. It is common practice for these groups to monitor communication channels for new open textbooks so they can let their network know. Sharing your resource in a catalog provides you with greater visibility for your work. With traditional publication processes, materials are entered into a database or catalog by either publishers or libraries as part of the process of making materials accessible. Making open text and resource accessible is often dependent upon the creator of the material. Working with open textbook publishers and organizations, for example, BC Campus, OpenStax, may provide you with an avenue for sharing your resources. OER repositories. While there are several ways to share your OER once you have created and licensed them, posting them to an OER educational resource repository is a great way to increase the accessibility and audience for your materials. Many repositories will always archive your material to ensure that they are available long term. By submitting your work in multiple repositories, it increases the chances that it will be discovered by educators and researchers looking for openly licensed content in your field. Some repositories require that the resource meets certain criteria, such as an evaluation by a subject matter expert. Here are a few examples of where you can apply depending on the type of OER that you have created. Additional high quality OER repository can be found in the resource section of this platform. I hope you've enjoyed this lecture. Thank you, and see you in week 4.